like this. So baytun, which means a house, baytun. We want to say the house, we would just connect the L onto it. We just connect the L onto it, and also we lose this tanween. The tanween is an indicator of a noun being indefinite. Don't worry about that too much. The point is that when we want to say the house, we use this word al, and it's connected onto the word that we're using it with. The house, al-bayt, al-bayt. All right, so let's look at an example with that in it. Let's look at an example with that in it. So let's consider the following sentence. We have this word here. All right, here's my al, and here's the noun it's connected to, bayt. All right, let's put in the vowels. So da, kha, and then lam with the sukun gives us dakhal. Da with a dhamma, do. Here's my al. I'm going to put my sukun on the lam. The ba takes a fatha. I've already put in the sukun on the ya, and the da is going to take a fatha. All right. This gives us what? It gives us dakhaltul bayt. In other words, we go straight from the dhamma on the da to the sukun on the lam, and we just completely ignore this alif. Remember, we said the word for the, I'm just going to write it down here, was al. Al. But this is a connecting hamza. You can tell there's because there's no hamza written in, it's invisible. Therefore, where it occurs in the middle of a sentence, as it does here, we completely ignore it. Dakhaltul bayt, which means I entered the house. In terms of a revision, I would honestly advise that you not revise this lesson. Understand what we said in part two about the connecting hamza, because that is very important, particularly the word al, which we'll come back to the next lesson, meaning the. But really, part one, just get a gist of it. Understand that the hamza can sit on top of different letters, and it all depends on the vowel on the hamza and maybe the vowel on the letter before it. But it's not really worth at this stage, I would say, trying to commit those rules to memory. You can do that after you've done some grammar. So don't bother revising this lesson, and I'll see you next time.